5 on your health now. Utah and Florida have already banned adding fluoride to public drinking water, and now the FDA is gearing up to ban prescription fluoride supplements. The CDC's recommended fluoride concentration is 0.7 milligrams per liter. Now, what does that mean? Well, that's about 3 drops in a 55-gallon barrel. HHS Secretary RFK Jr. wants to remove it altogether. He wants it out. HHS and the EPA are reviewing a report that links high levels of fluoride to lower IQ in children, but there was not enough data to determine what impact lower levels of fluoride could have.
It is a complex problem, and they should give money and funding to do the studies. So when we talk based on data, and we don't talk based on feelings.
Fluoride has been added to public water systems here in the United States since 1945.
Well, here to talk about this is a bit more is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Vice Chair of the Department of Medicine at South Shore Health. Always good to see you and to talk about this topic.
Good to see you, Jess.
Right? So is there a medically known risk of ingesting too much fluoride? I mean, say, for example, if a child uses more than a pea-sized amount of toothpaste.
Yeah. There is acute intoxication, taking too much, but I think what you're referring to is chronically. Mm-hmm. And yes, you definitely can have too much fluoride. It's called fluorosis. It can stain or stripe the teeth, so like a discoloration. Mm. Sometimes if it's worse, it can cause pitting and things. So yes, you can, but you have to take a lot of it. And I think that's one of the reasons why fluoride in the water is set at a very low level. It's about 0.7 milligrams per liter. You can think about it as like parts per million. So it's a low level.
Yeah, okay.
But you can have too much.
You can have too much. Okay, what are some of the benefits of having fluoride in drinking water?
Right, without question, the benefits have to do with decreasing cavities, decreasing tooth decay. So I think the story of fluoride is you don't want too little, and you don't want too much. It's sort of like that Goldilocks effect. You want to find the right amount. But there have been places in the U.S. that have taken fluoride out of the water, and there have been significant increases in cavities. So I think you have to be careful.
Already, too, because that was just recently, right? So who should be considered for prescription fluoride tablets and drops?
Right, so fluoride tablets, it's important to note that fluoride supplements, most people in the United States don't need that. Why? Because most parts of the United States do have fluoridated water. Mm-hmm. But if you don't have fluoridated water, all right, then it's important that you take supplements, fluoride supplements. Now, if you're not sure, talk to your dentist. Especially, we're talking about kids, even more important. So pediatric dentistry, it's relevant.
You talk about the importance of the amount, too. So important to talk to your dentist as well to figure out how much you should be having.
That's right. And remember, there's not a lot of fluoride in food, right? So there is some in toothpaste. But again, you want to know if you don't have fluoride in the water, if you don't go to the dentist regularly, if you're prone to cavities, it's these kids that really need the supplements.
Makes sense. Dr. Ellerin, we always appreciate your insights.
You too,
Jess. Good to see you.